Welcome to the first ever screencast of WAM. So WAM or WSO2 Update Manager is a simple command line application which allows you to keep your WSO2 products up to date. WAM is basically a tool that can be used to install latest updates on products from the WSO2 product stack, such as API Manager, Enterprise Service Bus and Identity Server. So let me explain the reason behind developing WAM. We improve our products on a daily basis with bug fixes, security fixes, and various other improvements. We call these improvements product updates, and these are issued to users as patch releases of products. Usually, our users have to wait for months for these patch releases, but with WAM, you can have continuous access to all our product updates as and when we release them. So, if you are yet to download WAM, visit wso2.com/update and follow the given instructions to download and install. Once the installation is completed, open a new terminal window and just type WAM. You should get an output similar to what you see on the screen with a list of available commands. First of all, to proceed with WAM, you need to have a WSO2 account. If you don't have an account, visit wso2.com/user/register and create one. If you have an account, then type WAM in it to continue. Enter your email address and password to get yourself authenticated. You're authenticated, and now let's see what WAM can do for you. Assume that you have a WSO2 ESB 490 based deployment, and now you need to install the latest updates available for ESB 490. WAM maintains a local product repository in your machine where it stores WSO2 product distributions. Whenever you update a product, WAM creates a new distribution with all these updates and stores it in this repository. By default, WAM creates this repository in the user's home directory, but you have the option to change this as well. So let's get back to our example. As I just explained, first you need to add WSO2 ESB 490 to the local repository. You need to use WAM add command for this, and there are two ways. You can either download a fresh distribution or add an already downloaded distribution. So to download a product, you need to specify the product name. If you're not sure on the format, you can use the WAM search command and it will list all the WAM supported products. Or else you can specify a keyword and search for matching products. You can see the search results. Now type WAM add WSO2 ESB to download the product. As you can see, it is trying to download the latest version of ESB, which is 5.00. But I need ESB 490, so I type ESB along with the exact version. Type yes to continue. As you can see, ESB 490 is being downloaded. Now the download is completed. Now if you check the local repository, you should be able to see the downloaded product. For this, you can use the WAM list command and it shows the downloaded ESB 490. Now let's check whether there are updates for WSO2 ESB 490. You can type WAM check update WSO2 ESB 490. It's checking for updates. So there seems to be 96 updates, including 11 security updates. We'll update the product now. Type WAM update WSO2 ESB 490. You can see the updates are being downloaded. And it builds a new distribution, including these downloaded updates. Once the update is completed, you should receive an email with the update summary. As you can see on the screen, we also include this summary in the updated distribution. In case these updates contain configuration changes, a diff of these changes will also be included in the distribution. If you want to test this updated product or push it to your staging environment, you can get it from this location. So now we have successfully updated ESB 490. As I explained earlier, WSO2 releases updates regularly, so we recommend you to keep your products up to date using WAM. One important thing to note here is that fresh WSO2 product distributions downloaded via wso2.com site or using WAM are licensed under Apache 2, but the updated distributions are licensed under WSO2 update license. Now let's try the WAM list command again. You can see the updated distribution as well as the first distribution. So we version the updated distributions using the timestamp of the latest installed update. If you want more details of any of the products in this list, you can use the warm describe command. Here you can see details such as file location and update history. So that's basically how WAM works. There are a few more features of WAM that I didn't explain. You can always get information on these features by just typing WAM. And if you need additional details of a command, you can use the help flag. And if you need further information, contact us at wso2.com/contact. Thank you.